come back from that short break, and of course we'll be kicking things off with a lot of games on Saturday afternoon.
Yep.
But at 6 p.m.
yep,
we'll be having two of the heavyweights taking to the field, with Liverpool hosting Crystal Palace.
Yep.
A side that's struggling for goals. They find themselves in 14th place.
Yep.
22 points, but Liverpool are current table toppers, 57 points, 4 points ahead of City.
Yeah, Tony, and this is a game where you expect Liverpool to maintain their position at the top. I believe against Crystal Palace, they should be able to see off this game. It's really surprising, Tony, that Crystal Palace were able to give us a shocking result at Etihad, beating Man City there. But they have not kicked on from that game. And this is a fixture you would have thought maybe Crystal Palace can come back and haunt Liverpool, but I don't see that. I don't see that.
Very, very interesting. Of course, we know that Liverpool have the best record, one of the best records at home in the league.
Yep.
They are on a six-game winning streak. Yep. At home right now, and they're unbeaten in 31 games.
Yep.
At home. So that shows you how well they perform in front of their fans. Of course, very, very interesting. And of course, for Crystal Palace,
yep,
they haven't had the number nine to pick up that mantle. Of course, we know Benteke has had a long spell out.
Yep,
injured.
Yep.
But of course, none of their strikers. Soloth has gone out now on loan to, yep, Ghent. So they need someone to turn up. Zaha's rallied them.
Yep.
Try and pick themselves up. It's a new year. You need to give us some new performances. They are very, very interesting there. But Salah,
yep,
will be looking to now make sure the golden boot is his, especially that Kane is out.
Yeah, Tony, with Kane injured, you look at the only computer being Aubameyang, who is struggling at the moment. So Salah is seeing this as something he can capitalize on. And these are the fixtures where Salah can get two goals or even a hat-trick in it. So I look at him trying to create the gap before Harry Kane comes back to compete with him.
Do you think Liverpool will keep up their winning streak?
Yeah, I think Liverpool win this, and with a good score of 3-0.
I've gone for 3-1 myself in this Liverpool game, and of course, at the same time, we'll be having Manchester United,
yep,
and inspired. They like to call it the new Manchester United. We'll be taking on Brighton and Hove, yep, Albion, a team that beat them at the beginning of the season.
Yeah, actually, they're the first team that beat Man United.
3-2.
Yeah, 3-2. And I think they will come back with the same hope that they can upset United at Old Trafford. The thing is, this is a new Man United. They have a lot of hungry players. We've had Sosha mention that Sanchez is now good to go, and I would expect him to start in that game tomorrow, Tony. It's a team that is happy. Everyone in United is happy. And
is that why they're having a lot of babies?
No, I think it's a coincidence. But this team, Tony, look at the likes of Lukaku. They're yearning for first team spot. And if he got it, I think they'll be too much for Brighton.
And of course, we know that Solskjaer has thoroughly improved this team.
Yep.
They've been in the form
five
of their lives,
yep,
5 games in a row in the league. They'll be looking to make it 6, of course, in this particular game. And Brighton have issues of their own.
Yep.
Matt Ryan, their number one choice goalkeeper, is away at the Asian Cup, of course, there. And it's Gero, their very, very, very
good
winger,
yep,
will be out of this one with an ankle injury. Gives Bissouma, another energetic midfielder, is out. So you see that he lacks some of the options.
Mm.
Chris Hughton going into this game. I've gone for 2-0 Man United.
I think Man United will win this 3-0. 3-0.
That's a big one for Manchester United and Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, who we had thought we are hearing might be taking an interview for that full-time job there. Everyone seems to be backing him for that particular game. He's done wonderfully well,
yep,
for Manchester,
yep,
United. Ever since he came in, of course, every player and the non-technical staff should be backing him for that one. And of course, on Sunday afternoon, we'll be having the rest of the big teams. Huddersfield will be hosting second-placed Manchester City in a game that will be very, very interesting. Huddersfield come into that game with no manager.
Yeah, they are managerless. They are at the bottom of the table. They've not won in 9 games. This is a horrible time to host Man City. And I don't see them leaving the table. And they're the first candidate to me who will go down this season, Tony.
It will be very interesting. Of course, they dismissed David Wagner this week, Huddersfield. And they will be coming into this game with caretaker manager Mark Hudson, with no Aaron Moy.
No Aaron Moy.
So you see that they still have a lot of problems to contend with. And Manchester City will be hoping to come into this one with, yeah, no fresh injury,
no
concerns. We only know that Benjamin Mendy is the only absentee there, and of course maybe we saw Kompany struggling in the last couple of games, so those are the only people playing outfield that will be out there. Gabriel Jesus has been in the form of his life,
yeah,
but Sergio,
yeah,
Aguero might be coming back into this one.
I think Sergio Aguero might come back, given that Man City has a midweek game of Carabao Cup Cup semi-final. So he has to juggle his side, and he has a 9-0 aggregate for the Carabao. So I don't know why he's been going to juggle this game. But City needs to keep the pace. The eye is on Liverpool, and they cannot slip away from the 4 points. I think 4 points is acceptable for Guardiola, and he can now keep the chase. So this is a winnable fixture for Man City.
Of course, he'll be hoping to come into that game with Liverpool having dropped some points. Of course, he doesn't want to keep chasing that 7-point gap. Yeah. Any slip up for him means trouble, of course, as Liverpool keep marching towards that title. So it will be very, very interesting. I've gone for 3-0 Man City.
I've given one more goal there, 4-0 Man City.
Big game, that one. And of course, after that, we'll be having the last game of the weekend. Spurs will be visiting Fulham, another London derby.
Yep.
Big game for Spurs, this one, testing Mauricio Pochettino. He took some time off this week.
Yep.
He's currently third, 48 points, 1 point ahead of Chelsea.
Yeah, Tony.
It's a big problem for him. These teams are coming fast, and with all these injuries.
Yeah, that's what...
What a problem for Pochettino.
It's a big problem. When you look at the game against Man United, it's not the result Pochettino will worry about. It is the outcome of the players after the game. Son has left for the Asian Cup. Sissoko had a groin injury there. Harry Kane is out for almost 2 months.
Now, the end of March.
You have to look at which team is he going to assemble now to push the team going forward. And I looked at the fixture against Fulham. They won 3-1 that fixture. Fulham had very good chances. They should have gone, I think, 2-0 up in that fixture. And going to Craven Cottage, I think it will be a hard game for Tottenham.
It's a problem, like you said, a lot of problems in the squad for for Pochettino to contend with. Dembele has left for China, of course.
Yep.
Wanyama is still a long-term absentee. In the midfield is where I see them growing really thin. Up front, it's
still okay.
It's easy to push the Eric Lamela's, Lucas Moura.
Yep.
We saw Moura playing in that Manchester United game up top with Kane, and he got a brace.
Yep.
So it's very interesting. The midfield is where he's very
lacking,
very having big problems. Only Harry Winks and Eric Dier, who hasn't played since December.
Yep.
So those are the only two senior guys. He might have to call on Oliver Skip.
Yep.
So it's a big problem for him there. But of course, they've won 9 out of 10 games against Fulham in the times that they've met. So this should be a winnable fixture, but will not be comfortable for Pochettino.
Yeah, it won't be comfortable. That's why I think I have my doubts in this fixture, Tony. And my prediction will tell it all.
2-1 for me.
No, Spurs. I have gone for 2-2. I think 2-2.
Very, very interesting prediction there, Tim, going for a 2-2 draw at Craven Cottage Sunday evening. Don't miss that game. It will be very, very scintillating. Some of these Fulham players are finally kicking on. We saw a brilliant goal from Andre Schuller last weekend. So it's a very, very interesting game. This you cannot afford to miss. And of course, we'll be having a lot more games. We'll be bringing you all the predictions as usual on our Facebook, Twitter and Instagram pages. Make sure you catch those for you out there that like to watch the show. And of course, click the like, subscribe to our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel as well to never miss any of our videos. And of course, elsewhere, we have a big game in Spain.
Yeah.
It's struggling Madrid, taking on a Sevilla team that beat them in the first leg 3-0.
Yeah, Tony, it's an interesting fixture. It's going to be at the Bernabeu. Both teams have 33 points, and Sevilla is just ahead because of that 3-0 win they had at their home. It's an interesting fixture. I think with the struggles of Madrid, these are the fixtures that they need to win and bring back the fans on their side.
Is this the time for Madrid to be airbrushing Cristiano out of their history?
This is the time. I think they are airbrushing him already.
Big, big problems for Santiago Solari, of course, there at the Bernabeu. We'll be waiting to see if they can make any more purchases in January. They already have taken Brahima Diaz from Manchester City, that 19-year-old, £22 million. So that goes to tell you how much they believe in him. They are very interesting game that comes on Saturday night. You cannot afford to miss that game. Very, very brilliant. And of course, we have nothing left to say for now. Goodbye and enjoy the weekend of football.
Goodbye.